At Pearl and York Roads in Parma Heights, traffic cameras sit idle, while opinions about them are revving up.
If they're running the lights all the time, then I feel like it should be up, you know?
We shouldn't bring them back because it's just bringing money in for the city when it's hurting more people when they have to constantly get tickets when, you know, it's hard enough to make money in the first place.
The city turned the cameras off in 2019 when it appeared state law would impact how and how much revenue they could collect. But now council's introduced new ordinances to restore them, including a portable handheld device with support from police, says Detective Adam Sloan.
So to have something like that as a deterrent is certainly very important, and safety is certainly one of our top priorities in our city. And as far as the handheld device goes, that is, similar in nature as far as safety for school zones and residential areas where we get actually a lot of complaints of speeders.
Speeding up to 9 miles per hour over the limit could cost you $100. 10 miles per hour and greater would be $200, and also $200 for school zone and red light violations, similar to before, which some drivers still think is unfair.
I think 5-6 miles an hour over the speed limit is acceptable, and they still get you. You're still paying. I myself got a ticket for $120. My dad got a ticket for $210.
But other motorists support the effort.
I'm a Lyft driver personally, and I drive, I'm driving all day. People running through the red lights, almost every light I'm at, I'll be sitting at a light, be sitting right behind me, they'll just come right around me just to run the red light. It's ridiculous.
The safety is a thing to keep in mind. These do create revenue. We're not going to hide from that. However, if you look at the numbers, it shows that it does help in those high traffic areas. It does help in school zones, and in those areas, we do get complaints of speeders.
In Parma Heights, Suzanne Stratford, Fox 8 News.